Hey, I'm Naomi Ekperigin.
I'm Dusty Slay.
I'm Brian Simpson.
I'm Mark Norman.
I'm Janelle James.
I'm Melissa Villaseñor, and this is Ask a Comedian. What rituals do I need to do before I go on stage? Well, go poop.
Poop, yeah.
I put Aquaphor on my lips. I don't like them when they're chapped and crunchy. Drink some water.
Oh, that's all the same shit I do before I get on a flight. I poop, I hydrate, and I pray that it doesn't crash.
Usually I have to talk myself out of smoking a joint.
That's a good one. Weirdly, I like to be alone in my hotel and get a little sad. Somehow, if I feel too confident about the show, I don't do as well. So I like to be a little sad and believe that it's not gonna work out and that I'll probably quit comedy right after this show.
I thought that's how we all were. I didn't know that was a ritual.
I don't know. Maybe that is what everyone does.
Malcolm X, I've never watched the whole thing because it's 4 hours long. I feel bad about that because I've watched Interstellar 6 times.
That one's long.
I know, and Malcolm X is like a Black History thing. But I know his story. I don't feel the need to watch 4 hours. But whenever people are talking about it, I do, yeah. So I'm fake.
I have a dumb joke about that I love that never works about how explaining a Peloton to someone in a third world country. You know, the idea of this $2,000 bicycle that doesn't go anywhere. And then the only reason you use it is because it burns calories from like takeout. And they're like, what's takeout? And they're like, that's where a guy on a bicycle brings food to your house. And it always bombs. But when I wrote it, it was killing in my room. You know what I mean?
Oh, that's always the best.
Yeah.
A joke I love to tell is about how the video game Animal Crossing is basically just slavery cosplay. And no one really likes it, but I stand by it. I don't understand why you would play a game where you have to till a field and tend, and you get told what to do by animals.
I identify with my zodiac sign. I don't know a whole lot about astronomy world, but I'm a Libra, October 9th. John Lennon was also on that day. I think I connect with Libras because we're indecisive, artistic, selfish.
I should get credit for all the time that I spend pretending to be interested in astrology. Other people talk about it, and it's my own personal, like, torture.
I'm a Taurus, and I read it, and I'm like, oh yeah, that's totally me. I'm 100% that guy. So I do think I do, even though I don't believe in it.
I'm a Libra. I also tell myself I don't believe in it, but then I read that we're pretty.
I'm a Virgo, which is pretty analytical, annoying. So yeah, that's dead on, but it's all silly. I feel like it's made up and it makes people feel better about their stupid decisions.
I'm a Sagittarius and I don't know much about it, but I do know it's a half man, half horse, which is rude. I take it personally, it's hurtful, and I do not identify.
I've done comedy in laundromats, pizza parlors, barbershops. I just did a show in like a closed Abercrombie & Fitch.
It closed down?
Yeah, it was closed. It was like completely empty, nothing on the shelves.
I just remembered I performed in a hat shop. Gurin Hats? I left with a hat, they gave me one.
Strangest place I ever performed comedy was in a food museum in New Orleans in front of my parents and their friends. And boy, did I eat a bag of dog shit. And it reminded my parents why I shouldn't be a comic.
Strangest gig I ever had was at the Young Nudists of America winter gathering. You know, it's hard to find things to do in the cold weather when you want to be naked. And comedy is just a great option for people. They can be inside. Bring a towel. That's the rule among the nudists. You got to put a towel on that seat. Then you can sit on it. And then I'm supposed to tell you jokes without looking at your areolas.
Once in Winston-Salem, North Carolina, I did comedy standing on a bar and the mic had a sticky stuff all over it. And I kept like looking at my hand to see if there was tape on there. And they thought I was reading my jokes. That was pretty strange.
I can't remember the name of this town, but I remember the sign when you drive in, it's the home of Ronald Reagan. So wherever he was born, a VFW in the Midwest, it was a talent show. And I came in second to an Elvis impersonator.
Tough to beat Elvis.
This was Ask a Comedian.
Now go watch the Standups Season 3.
Only on Netflix.